Hi, my name is Heather, I'm from Professional Palette, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make up a male model. If you've qualified from college or just recently finished, sometimes the concept of doing a male can be a little bit intimidating, especially seeing as most of the people you've practiced on will probably be females on the course. So what I'm going to show you how to do today is I'm going to show you how to do it a little bit more eccentric, so to take it to a catwalk look. Because I've got Jack, who's got a really good sculpture to his face, I'm going to show about sculpturing and contouring and highlighting. So I'm going to put quite a lot of makeup on him, considering it's still going to look fairly natural. And just what products you use and what different products you can use for men that you maybe might not use for women. Okay. On the catwalk, you don't always have time to quickly in between changes fully prep the skin, but the prep's really important. So these studio wipes by e.l.f. are really, really good. They've got shea butter in them, so it sort of moisturises a little bit at the same time. Now, Jack hasn't got anything on at the moment. His skin's really good anyway, naturally. So I'm just gonna wipe over quickly, and just because of the video and the time scale. At this point, sometimes you might need to do like a quick peel or a quick chemical exfoliation, like clarify by Clinique, something like that, just if there's any dry skin. Sometimes you might need to neaten up the beard, but Jack shaved today, or the eyebrows. You can fill these in generally with like a coloured mascara or a powder, so if there is any gaps in the beard, just to give it more definition. I'm going to use MAC Face and Body Foundation because it goes on quite light, then I'll build it up with the powders and stuff. And just a foundation brush. You can use this all over the body. Don't be shy with the foundation, even though it's on men, because it might look like they've got a lot on and they might feel like they've got a lot on, but as soon as they start shooting, it will look completely different. Airbrushing is really good for this as well, if you're in a rush to just airbrush the men. That gives a good effect. What we'll do in some other videos for you later on, we'll show you how to airbrush, and we'll do the airbrushing of the full body. If you do want to do something a little bit more, you can use Jean-Paul Gaultier's makeup line, which is really good. You can actually get it on Boots online now. So we'll take it right down to his neck later on, but we'll just do his face for now so you can see the difference. So with sculpturing, it's really important to highlight any features that stick out, just like you would a woman, and anything you want to look more shaded or contoured, always use a darker shade and something quite matte, because any shimmer will show up and it'll look obvious on a man that you're wearing makeup. So I'm just going to use a few pinks, a bit of green in the concealer palette, and a little bit of the yellow for the redness, and just mix those together. It should always be lighter in the centre, so we just need to lighten that up for him now, and we'll do the contouring properly with the powder. If you've got any pores, you might want to cover those in as well, any piercings, anything like that. Just put your eyes closed for me, Jack. So we are going to use eyeshadow. You don't always have to use eyeshadow on the males, but we're just going to use a matte one. You won't be able to see he's got eyeshadow on, really, especially for the sort of shots we're going to be doing with Simon later on. Lip balm, lip exfoliates, things like that, usually a good one to use on the men. So. Okay, so clear mascara just for the brows. Just going to colour them in first with an eyebrow pencil. I think the best eyebrow pencil on the market is definitely the Clinique Superfine Liner. It's the finest one you can get, and the shades are really good as well. But you can get a real, like it's actually a hair stroke effect. And then I just run a powder through it. Also, another good one is Tom Ford for using for men, because it's got like a powdered base to it. And then I'll just put a little bit of powder on with either a liner brush or just a small eyeshadow brush. Just a little bit of brown underneath and just in the corner. I've got this, my friend brought me this back from Marrakesh. It's the old way they used to do eyeliner, Egyptian sort of style. And all it is, it's just a little black pen. You fill it there with the powder that you're going to be using. And it's just like a little wood stick. But it gives a more natural effect. And just dip it in the end there. When you've finished using it, you can wash the stick and just dry it on a radiator. Okay. So all he needs to do is just look right up to the ceiling. And close your eye for me. And you pull it along. Same again, just look right up for me. And close your eye. And you don't want to get it right on the rim, but you want to get as close as you can. Okay, I'm going to define his lip a little bit. Just doing that for me. Okay. I don't want this to look too shiny. So I'll matte this down now with some powder. And then I'm just going to do a little bit of Jack's chest and just his neck area. And I'm just going to use this highlighter. This is by Estee Lauder. So I'm just going to put a little bit of that on his chest here. And I'm just going to make just his collarbone stand out here. But this will stand out in the light, just at the top of his cheekbones, just a little bit. Just down the bridge of his nose in the centre, a little bit at the top. And then you need to finish it with a setting spray when you've finished. And then just a little bit of a pinky brown shade. Again, this is Estee Lauder, just like a plummy colour. I'm going to really go to town on it, so just suck your cheeks in for me a minute, please, Jack. Like that, yeah. So it's going to look quite intense. It might look a bit silly in this light at the moment and look like he's got a lot of makeup on, but you'll see what I mean when you see the finished shots. Just down the side of his nose here as well. It's just that sculpture, just a little bit at the top there, just in the crease. That's great. And that's how to do men's makeup for more of a catwalk look. And you'll see the pictures later and you'll see what I mean about the sculpturing once he's doing his shoot. So thank you for watching me and Jack doing this tutorial. I'm